The human mind has always had the craving to know the unknown. We wish to know the world around us, its source, its meaning, and its probable future. Our ancestors have done much research in this area, but their findings were hidden in ancient manuscripts, inaccessible to the common man. This was something which bothered young Jagannath Ganesh Gune, who was a graduate in arts and had started traveling from village to village, joining Lokmanya Tilak's home rule movement.
He started working in some capacity with the famous Marathi daily, edited by then Lokmanya Tilak himself. Later on, he thought that it is good to get involved the youth in this freedom movement, but they should be disciplined. Therefore, he separated himself and thought to start an educational institute which was known as a national college, and he started in Amalnir. He introduced their physical education, Indian physical education, Malcolm, Lathi, etc., etc., British inspector of police, to feel that he might be preparing these youth to become the freedom fighters. Therefore, the national college was banned. So once the college was banned, he decided to return to Baroda at the place of his maternal uncle. And there he heard about a yogi. His name was Madhudasi Maharaj. Got influenced very much. Started visiting him again and again. And he was trained in yogic practices. And after receiving his training, he went in a secluded place somewhere in Himalayas. And once he returned on the Guru Purnima day to visit him, he asked him, what is the use of being alone? And what is the use of practicing only for yourself? There are thousand and thousand people practicing only for themselves. Do something which is beneficial to the society and the human being. And fortunately, in Amalnir, he met Pratap Sheth, who was an industrialist. He readily appreciated his idea and donated 5,000 rupees. And with the help of those 5,000 rupees, he bought a laboratory having some apparatuses, blood testing, the air testing, and so many other tests. Because those days the X-ray was not invented.
Dashmi Day in 1924, at the picturesque foothills of Lonavala, a hill station between Mumbai and Pune, foundation to Kevaladham was laid by Swami Khuvalyananda, dedicated in the memory of his guru Madhav Das Ji.
About the yogic practices, how does the kriyas affect, how asanas affect, how pranayama is affecting, what happens in samadhi, what is the difference between samadhi and hypnotized condition. So that is how the whole process of yogic evolution continued. On one hand, the traditional teachers were there. On another hand, traditional teachers with the scientific outlooks also were there. Those who wanted to tell what is the scientific basis of yogic practices.
The Philosophico Literary Research Department.
Philosophical Literary Research in Yoga deals with the qualitative aspect. We work to find out the resources which are scattered in the scripture, and that too in Sanskrit language. And Sanskrit language is not understandable to the people. There are many manuscripts on yoga, but when we go through the different manuscript libraries, we find that they have classified yogic manuscripts under the tantras or the under philosophy or something else. Our researchers published one catalog of yoga manuscripts in 1989. That catalog gives the information around 2000 manuscripts. We have collected around 1200 manuscripts in the Xerox form. So when we go through the manuscript, if we find that a particular manuscript gives the important information which is very useful for the society, we write a kind of introduction and immediately publish it so that this can reach to the people. We have published many critical editions like Hatpadipika, Gerind Samhita, Shiv Samhita. So recently we have published 4 volumes of Yoga Concordance. When we go through the literature, we find many references along with citations. So we go on collecting such material, and when this material becomes voluminous, we classify that and we publish it in the book form. The popular books can be understood by the common people. Swamiji has written 2 masterpieces, Pranayama and Asana. These are relevant today even. We have published one Yoga Kosh. This Yoga Kosh gives you the information, reference to the context with regard to practice or as well as the concepts. We have taken almost all the religions, Vedic, non-Vedic, as well as the non-Indian, the spiritual systems like Sufism, like Christianity, Islam. Though they have not given the yogic terms in their religion, but the concepts are the same. Whatever the experiment we are carrying out in our scientific research department, that we are publishing in Yog Mimamsa, which is a research quarterly journal, so that it can reach to the masses. Kevaladham has its own research library. At present, we have more than 26,000 titles at our disposal. This library has fully computerized. Internet facilities are available. In all, the Philosophical Literary Research Department is exploring the fundamental aspect of yoga so that it can be applied for the all-round development of mankind.
Crucial part of the Kevaladham, which really placed it on the international map, is the scientific research department.
Madhavdas ji Maharaj kaha karte the ki ab log purane dharm se hamare dada pardada keh rahe isliye karna ye manne wale nahi logo ke shraddha nahi rahe. तो आधुनिक विज्ञान के दृष्टि से हमें योग की उपयुक्तता और महत्ता
को
लोगों को बताना होगा और तभी लोग इसका स्वीकार करेंगे. और इसलिए हमें साइंटिफिक रिसर्च योग में करना है.
इन दिस साइंटिफिक रिसर्च डिपार्टमेंट वी हैव
physiology section, psychology section, radiology section, then neuropsychology, biochemistry, physical education. In psychology section, you'll be seeing various experiments. The constant gazing towards a point, towards a light. And when tears come out, at that time, we can enter into the subconscious level of our mind. And at that time, we can expose what we are there inside of our mind. If you have the psychological stress, tension, anxiety, it affects our physiological organs. And that is, to some extent, people they know. And this experiment, you can see here, that is about this your stomach, how it is upset when a person is psychologically stressed. And if we give meditation or dhyana, we can see that within 10 minutes, it has our stomach, upset condition of our stomach, it becomes normal. We are doing research work, how yoga helps to improve your eye-hand coordination. Can yoga help in that way? So we have experiments and we could see that yoga helps to improve the eye-hand coordination of the person. In the physiology section, we have done some experiment and we could find that if a person is doing yoga or asana in a relaxed way, so his physiological functionings are different and conducive for your health. Whereas if you practice it just like exercise, isometrically or isotonically, your impact is different. Now if a heart patient is doing that exercise or that asana, like exercise, positively he will be getting heart problem or intensity of suffering will be more. After yoga practices, the blood sugar level in diabetes, it has come down. The asthmatic patients, they are relieved when they are practicing yoga. We have presented this in international conference and we have got first prize for that. So similarly, in physical education section, we have done research work so far as health and fitness is concerned. So for health and fitness, nowadays the people, they are so aware of that they are going to gym, they are practicing exercises and they are keeping themselves fit. And they are spending lots of money for that. Whereas yoga, it can be practiced in simply 6 feet by 6 feet area inside the room. And there is no need of money. So without that, you can improve or you can at least maintain your physical fitness level to live fit in this world.
The GS College of Yoga and Cultural Synthesis. As the fame of the institute spread throughout the world, a large number of young enthusiasts started learning yoga at the ashram. To train them properly in yogic physical culture, the Govardhan Das Seksaria College of Yoga and Cultural Synthesis was opened in 1950.
In the beginning, we had only diploma in yoga education, and then later on in 1959, certificate course in yoga to cater to the needs of the people, those who want a kind of yoga exposure, but they don't want to be, say, teachers. This college is a center for many courses. Now the new additions are diploma in yoga therapy. So here, already the students, those who are having some exposure in yoga, and those who are educated in universities, are given admissions, provided they are graduates of biological sciences or medical sciences. So also we have advanced teachers training certificate course in yoga. So those who are teaching in some good institutions, they are given admission so as to hone further their professionalism in yoga teaching and training. So this is 1 month course, and we give 12 hours a day yoga training to them. This is very popular because we give the higher and the very subtler yoga practices to these people. Apart from that, we also go to the corporate sector as far as stress management workshops are concerned. And when they want some kind of special training for their executives, And so also many other institutions, they want us to speak on yoga. We also do sometimes some kind of collaborative studies and collaborative some write-up with the other countries, for example, Korea, whereby whatever we teach here, this course is reflected in that, so that when these Korean, they come, they don't find any difficulty in their own language, because normally they are not good in English. Diploma in yoga education is recognized by National Council of Teacher Education. And our certificate course is recognized by NIOS. And we have recognition from Education Ministry and Maharashtra government. In Korea, in USA, when you go for any kind of job, they straightway ask, have you been graduated from Kevala Dharma? So immediately then they give the employment in universities.
Along with the spiritual and physical culture, a number of patients suffering from various diseases started coming to Kevalya Dham. For them, the SADT Gupta Yogic Hospital was created in 1961. This was the first ever hospital in India devoted exclusively for the treatment of chronic functional disorders through yoga.
In 1955, I had a very severe attack of asthma in Bombay. And I went to see all the leading doctors. They were saying that you cannot get cured from this disease. This will be lifelong. Fortunately, somebody told me that why don't you try Kevalya Dham? I came to Kevalya Dham at Marin Drive and met Dr. Patel there. He looked at me. He said, you want to get cured? I said, yes. Then will you do whatever I tell you to do? I said, certainly. I will do whatever you tell me to do. He took down my history and then he told me, yes, you can start we can start the treatment. You come from tomorrow. And by the grace of God, I started improving. And slowly, I got well. Then, there was at that time, Bhushanji, who was in charge of Kevalya Dham, Bombay. He took me there to Swami Kovalyananda. And I told him that I feel that your institution is doing humanitarian work, is curing people, and I am very much impressed, and I would like to do something for this institution. Then one day he called me and said, Gupta ji, aap Lonavala mein hospital bana sakenge? Main kaha, Swami ji, aapko to maine kaha tha ki main kuch karna chahta hu, to aapki kripa se banayenge. In due course of time, the hospital was built, and with great pomp and show, the opening was done. People started coming, and because of the staff and the doctors, they were all devoted and loving. Even Tiwari ji at that time used to treat people. Yoga is not exercises alone. Yoga can take you right up to God. Yoga is such a powerful thing that if you want to be one with God, it is possible, because yoga itself means union with God.
संडे के दिन जब पेशेंट आते हैं तो पहले उनका अकोमोडेशन हो जाता है और उसके बाद पहला जो वर्क होता है वो मेडिकल चेकअप का होता है। तो उस वक्त मेडिकल रूम में आकर वो पहले हम उनको चेक करते हैं, तो वहाँ हम तय करते हैं उसकी प्रकृति क्या है, उसके प्रॉब्लम्स क्या है, विकृति क्या है, और उसके अनुसार उस हफ्ते में उनको हम क्या क्या दे सकते हैं तय कर लेते हैं। तो हमारे यहाँ तीन डिपार्टमेंट है, एक योगिक डिपार्टमेंट है, एक नेचुरोपैथी डिपार्टमेंट है और एक आयुर्वेदिक डिपार्टमेंट है। तो तीनों डिपार्टमेंट में हम उन पेशेंट को क्या क्या दे सकते हैं ये हम संडे के दिन ही तय कर लेते हैं।
तो जैसे हमारे यहाँ थेरेपियाँ हैं, मसाज थेरेपी है, तो मसाज जो है आयुर्वेदिक पद्धति से देते हैं, एक्यूप्रेशर पॉइंट से देते हैं। डिपेंड करता है पेशेंट के ऊपर, उसकी एज के ऊपर, उसकी कैपेसिटी के ऊपर और उसकी प्रॉब्लम्स के ऊपर। मसाज के बाद बाष्प स्नान लेना अत्युत्तम माना गया है। मड थेरेपी, ये मिट्टी जो है वो शुद्ध मिट्टी होती है, सबसे ही आसान तरीका और लाभकारी और गुणकारी है। ये मिट्टी हर प्रकार की हीट को जो है या दूषित पदार्थों को वो घोल करके बाहर निकालता है। पाइन बात है, मेरुदंड स्नान है, तो मेरुदंड जो है अपने रीढ़ की हड्डी के कड़ापन को दूर करता है। पट्टी स्नान जो है ये एक विशेष आकार का टब होता है, इसमें पानी जो है नाभि तक भर दिया जाता है और उसमें पेशेंट को बैठना होता है, पांव बाहर रहते हैं, सिर पे गीला कपड़ा रख दिया जाता है। ट्रीटमेंट जो है वो पेशेंट की एज, उसकी प्रकृति, उसकी प्रॉब्लम को अनुसार दिया जाता है। इसकी अवधि 10 से 15, 2 से 5, 5 से 7 मिनट तक होती है। जनरली हम यहाँ पर योगी की ही फूड देते हैं, विदाउट ऑनियन, विदाउट गार्लिक। फिर भी किसी की प्रॉब्लम के हिसाब से अगर उसकी डाइट में कोई चेंज करना है, परिवर्तन करना है, तो यहाँ से डाइट लिख के जाती है और वही उनको अपने भोजनालय में उपलब्ध हो जाती है।
As far as the healthcare center is concerned, we would extend our activities to executive trainings. And most importantly, affiliate with all the major hospitals throughout India and abroad to offer complementary and alternative yoga therapy in the hospital itself.
After living a richly creative life and seeing the tree of yogic culture grow from the seed sown in 1924 to a worldwide movement, Swami Kuvalyananda passed away on 18th April 1966. Swami Digambarji, disciple of Swami Kuvalyananda, succeeded as the spiritual head of the institute until 1990. Presently, Swami Maheshananda, chairman, is our spiritual guide.
Yoga has a complete message for the body, the human body, for the mind, and for the soul. Now the soul is beyond. Now that soul is that substance. Because it exists, the body is exist and the body is alive. Practices of yoga start with the body. So some groups and some persons start with the body and always remain with the body because they prefer the body is more important. Then some others are there. They are starting with the body, but they try to go beyond the body. Beyond the body, the mind. Beyond the mind, the area we know as a soul. Now the soul concept comes in the spirituality. In Yoga Sutra, Patanjali Yoga Sutra, tapas, swadhyaya, Ishvara pranidhanani kriya yoga. Swadhyaya, self-study, to know about the own self, who am I, how am I, and why am I. You investigate through different way, different methods, different technique. Then Ishvara pranidhana. Surrender to that absolute principle. Here it is known as Ishvara. We have, from the ancient traditional point of view, from the Vedic time of view, from that we have Pujana and Havana. That Pujana and Havana, here on this place, we do regularly as a part of Ishvara Pranidhana. Students learn about Ishvara Pranidhana. Students has a possibility to practice Ishvara Pranidhana, the surrender.
In the late 20s, Swamiji was invited by no less a person than Mahatma Gandhi to treat him for certain ailments and also to obtain instructions regarding his exercise and diet. In fact, Swamiji went to the Nandi Hills near Bangalore, Karnataka, and stayed with Gandhiji to give him treatment for quite a few days and then followed it up with regular correspondence. Prominent among Swamiji's students were Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Pandit Motilal Nehru, Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, and many others. Swamiji's work received further recognition when it became subject of discussion in the Parliament in 1949 between Dr. H. V. Kamath and Dr. B. R. Ambedkar. It was asserted by Dr. Kamath that there have been yogic ashrams, but they are different from institutes which carry on research in the spiritual field. The only institute which has been doing this work, to my knowledge, in scientific manner, in the spiritual field, is Kevale Dham, Institute of Lonavala.
सर्वप्रथम मी केवल्य धाम या संस्थेला मनापासून त्यांचं अभिनंदन करतो. या योगाच्या क्षेत्रामध्ये आपण फार मोठं संशोधन केलेलं आहे, त्याला सायंटिफिक काय आधार असतो हे पण जगापुढे आणलेलं आहे. आणि आज आपण जे उर्दूमध्ये योगासंदर्भावरचे पुस्तक आपण इथं प्रकाशित केलं, त्याच्यामुळे सुद्धा एक चांगला नवा संदेश गेलेला आहे. धर्मनिरपेक्ष योगा हे कुठल्या एका विशिष्ट धर्म आणि जातीपुरतं मर्यादित नाही आहे, हे सर्वांच्या आरोग्यासाठी हे आवश्यक आहे. अशा प्रकारचा संदेश आपल्या कैवल्यधामच्या संस्थेच्या वतीने आज सर्वदूर गेलेला आहे.
मोर दॅन 4,000 पीपल अटेंड कैवल्यधाम एव्हरी इयर अँड लर्न योगिक एक्सरसाइजेस. मोर दॅन 1,70,000 पीपल हॅव बीन काउंटेड ऑन रोल्स सिन्स इट्स इन्सेप्शन. देर आर सेंटर्स एल्सवे टू, लाईक इन मुंबई, भोपाल, अहमदाबाद, राजकोट, whose functioning is in tune with the overall functioning of the Institute of Kevale Dham. France and USA have their own Kevale Dham centers. In the year 1965, Swami Kuvalananda nominated his disciple Shri O.P. Tiwari as the honorary secretary of the TRUM every year and learn yogic exercises. More than 1,70,000 people have been counted on rolls since its inception. There are centers elsewhere too, like in Mumbai, Bhopal, Ahmedabad, Rajkot, whose functioning is in tune with the overall functioning of the Institute of Kevale Dham. France and USA have their own Kevale Dham centers. In the year 1965, Swami Kuvalananda nominated his disciple Shri O.P. Tiwari as the honorary secretary of the trust.
We do recognize that the Government of India, Ministry of HRD, has been helping the institute since 1949 towards its research activities and the training. So I would say that it has been only because of these grants that we have been able to carry on our activity to the strength we are today. But at the same time, we need to ensure that the institute stands up on its own feet. So one of the most important aspects which we are trying to achieve maybe in next decade or two is self-autonomy in financial matters. Specifically coming down to the research activities, I think we would, I'm sure that we would strive towards greater collaborations with other institutes, research organizations and research centers, both in field of scientific research, applied and the philosophical literary research. As far as the fundamental research, which was Swamiji's specialization, I would say, we would carry on the activities in the sublime practices of yoga more in depth, since it is hardly happening anywhere else in the world except at Kevaledham. So we are looking at this wide vision, and we hope that we would succeed in time to come. Yes, the government of India and government of Maharashtra both have been very helpful, and I'm sure they would be, but we look for a time when Kevaledham would be self-sufficient and striving towards achieving the goals laid down by the founder, Swami Kevaledham.